at thermal equilibrium current density from metal to semiconductor is equals to current density from semiconductor to metal, and that must be proportional to the number of electrons thermionically emitted. I am taking the mod because the sign may be different, it may be negative, it may be positive. So, at thermal equilibrium means you see that we have started from this thing Nth equals to Nc exponential minus q phi b n by k t. This we have seen in case of the, it is the electron density for the thermionically emitted electrons, okay? Thermionic emission, that is the electron current density. Now, this is the current density at thermal equilibrium, that means there will be two things, one is from metal to semiconductor or from semiconductor to metal, and that current density must be proportional to the number of electrons thermionically emitted from the semiconductor to the metal. Okay. Now, when a forward current, that means we can write that this is equals to C 1 n c exponential minus q phi b n by k t. Right. Why there is C 1? Constant of proportionality. Right. So, it is at thermal equilibrium. Now, when a forward current, when a forward bias V f is applied to the contact, electrostatic potential difference across the barrier is reduced. The electron density is now how much? Same thing, Nth is equals to Nc exponential minus q phi b n minus v f by k t. Okay, you agree? N c exponential minus q phi b n minus v f by k t. This v f is the forward bias which is lowering the built in potential. Now, if you apply a reverse bias, suppose v r, then what should be the expression? Yes, it should be phi b n plus v r, right? Phi b n plus v r. And you see that if you see this view graph, that means this is the positive potential which is being subtracted from the built in potential. That means on application of a positive voltage, it is reducing, and on application of a reverse voltage, it is increasing, right?
Sir,
yes.
In case of Schottky diode,
yes.
The depletion region is electrically neutral.
Depletion region?
No,
no, no. Electrically neutral will be there to as a whole.
Whole system.
Yes, a whole system, it will be electrically neutral. Okay? But there will be an electric field here.
There are only positive ions.
Yes, there are positive ions.
So, how do
you total system it is conserved. But so far as the depletion region, if you consider separately, then it is not maintained. Because on the depletion region only positively charged ions are there. So, it is not maintained.
The gradient of ions will be there.
Yes, gradients of ions will be there. Gradients of ions will be there, because not that it is constant. There will be with distance it is increasing basically. If you go from x equals to 0 to the bulk, from x equals to 0, that means contact to the bulk, it is increasing.
In case of PN increasing, the depression will be neutral.
Yeah.
But in that case,
it is not there. Okay. Now, it has some applications also. In my next class, probably on Thursday, I shall show you that how a Schottky junction solar cell is built out of this principle, how a photo detector is built out of this principle, and they are very efficient and very simple. Okay. So, now the electron density is this. Therefore, net current J is equals to J semiconductor to metal minus J metal to semiconductor. This is equals to C1 NC exponential minus Q phi BN by KT minus VF minus C1 NC exponential minus Q phi BN by KT. Okay? So, this is the net current, that means you are applying a forward bias. So, the current is becomes this, which will be subtracted from that thing. This is equals to C1 NC e to the power minus Q phi BN by KT into e to the power Q VF by KT minus 1. So, that is the net current. Okay. And this is the C1NC. This C1NC is a coefficient C1NC. This is known as A star T square, where A star is known as the effective Richardson constant. Effective Richardson constant, and its unit is ampere per Kelvin square centimeter square, the unit of Richardson constant. It depends on the effective mass. Okay. And what is the value of this A star? The value of A star is value is for N type silicon, P type silicon, N type gallium arsenide and P type gallium arsenide. There are 4 cases we will encounter. This is 110 for N type, 32 for P type, 8 for N gallium arsenide and 74 for P gallium arsenide. Okay. And the unit is A per Kelvin square centimeter square. These are the values for the effective Richardson constant, and the value will be given in the numerical problem, it will be given. Okay. So, now you see that this is the net current, and if I write down the net current, I can consider this to be J S or the saturation current. This is J S, which is known as the saturation current. So, net current J can be equals to J S e to the power Q V by K T minus 1, where J S is equals to A star T square e to the power minus Q phi B n by K T. J S is known as saturation current density. (coughs) Okay. Now, in this expression, if it is forward bias, it will be positive, V will be positive. It is reverse bias, V will be negative. So, this is the expression for the current density for a metal semiconductor Schottky junction. Metal semiconductor Schottky junction. Now, what you see from this expression? You see from the expression that if you know the reverse saturation current, you can calculate barrier height. Phi V n is calculated, it can be determined if you know the J s. Now, how it is known? It is known from the I V characteristics or the J V characteristics. J V characteristics. Okay. Extrapolating the forward J V curve to V equals to 0, we can find J S. That means, you are in a position to determine the barrier height from the I V characteristics. J V curve means it is nothing but the I V characteristics. I am not using here the I V, because here that expression is in terms of J. So, you have to divide by the area of the contact. It can be say 0.1 millimeter square if it is a very small dot of gold on silicon, or say very small dot of aluminum on silicon, then the area of the dot is the area of the device, effective area of the device. It can be say 0.1 millimeter square, 1 millimeter square, 0.01 millimeter square. You can measure that thing. So, once you measure this thing, you can calculate the phi B n from the value. Now, you can, I can show you that this is the forward current versus the voltage. It is forward biasing, you see, for two cases. One is silicon on silicon, where tungsten is tungsten contact is made. Here the same tungsten constant contact is made on gallium arsenide. Okay, you see that it is seen by this arrow, the value of the J S. The J S can be measured from the extrapolating the J V curve to V equals to 0. This axis V is 0. On this axis V is 0. So, extrapolating this curve to V axis will give you the value of J S. Once you know the J S, you can calculate the barrier height. Yes. Let us take this example. For a tungsten silicon Schottky diode with N D equals to 10 to the power 16 centimeter cube inverse, find the barrier height and depletion layer width from the figure below. Just you calculate the barrier height, that is all. You need not to calculate any other thing, depletion layer width or comparison, that is not required, because we have not completed the whole discussion. For time being, you just calculate the barrier height from this curve. It is tungsten silicon Schottky diode with N D equals to 10 to the power 16. So, what you need actually? A star, you know, tungsten silicon, what is the A star? What is the value of A star I have given? No, A star is not for tungsten or anything, it is for silicon.
110.
T is how much? 300 Kelvin. Q, you know, or it can be in electron volt, the result will be in electron volt. K T at room temperature is 26 millielectron volt or 0.26 electron volt. So, then you can calculate phi b n. Then you can calculate phi b n, you calculate. How the phi b n can be calculated? Yes. This current, I have shown you that it is basically the current at zero biasing, at zero biasing, I equals to I 0 e to the power e v by k t, when v equals to 0, I equals to I 0. No. Normally, saturation current is the current, then it suddenly increases. Before breakdown, it just increases. Otherwise, it remains constant. That is why it is known as saturation. You see that this phi b n equals to k t ln a star t square by how much? J s. This expression J s by a star t square, then take log of both sides, you will get phi b n equals to k t ln a star t square by j s, right. Now, what is k t? K t is 0.0259 electron volt multiplied by ln, what is a star? 110, t square is 300 square by j s. What is the value of j s? You see that for silicon, here it is the value of the J s, okay. The value of the J s is, it is the value of the J s, it is equals to 6.5 into 10 to the power minus 5. Please write down the value, 6.5 into 10 to the power minus 5, 6.5 into 10 to the power minus 5. Ampere per centimeter square, obviously here. So, that will give you 0.67 volt. So, barrier height can be calculated from the IV characteristics, okay. This is 0.67 electron volt. So, if you know the JV or the IV characteristics, you can calculate the barrier height from the IV measurements, okay. Any question on this? 0.67 volt. If you multiply by Q, then it will be electron volt, okay. Very simple. If you want to tell in the electron volt, then you have to tell that it is Q into phi b n. KT is in electron volt, right. No, better.
The value of KT is in volt.
KT by Q is electron volt. No. See, actually it is this thing, then this Q goes to here, then KT by Q becomes this thing in volt, then it is volt. Clear? it is in volt. Okay. Now, we shall consider the case of CV measurements. It is from IV. Now, from CV measurements, we shall consider what is the value of the barrier height, and that is very interesting also. You see that when the metal semiconductor junction is made, the depletion width will extend inside the semiconductor region. Why? The depletion region will extend inside the semiconductor region? No, it is because the, say, for p-n junction, let us, it is a p-n junction. The depletion layer width will depend on the carrier concentration on both the sides. Suppose the carrier concentration here is 10 to the power 15, it is 10 to the power 18. Carrier concentration is 10 to the power 15 on the p side and 10 to the power 18 on the n side. Then how the depletion layer width will look like? It will look like this thing. It is more on the p side. Why? Because of the low doping. Because of the low doping. Basically, the total charges will be same on both the sides. Distance multiplication, the product between the distance and the number of charges.
Number of carrier diffusion will be same.
Not here the diffusion is same. Here the uncompensated charges. Here the because in the depletion region there is no carrier, only the uncompensated ions are there. Yes.
Here the density in n side is more. So, probability of transferring from n to p side is more. So, more uncompensated charge particles should be there in n side. More?
No. Actually, there will be here, say, this is x 1 say, and this is x 2 say, x 1 will be x 2 multiplication, that means charge q on x 1 must be equals to charge q on x 2, total charge, total value. Okay. The charge will be the same. So, that means it will be multiplied by the distance. So, it will be say n a n d, this will be same, this will be same. If n d greater than n a, if n d greater than n a, that means x 1 must be greater than x 2. If n d greater than n a, then x 1 must be greater than x 2, right. So, that is because of the total uncompensated charge on both the sides of the metallurgical junction will be same. So, we can conclude that the region where it is lightly doped, the depletion layer width will be more. Right. So, depletion layer width will be more in this side. So, now if you consider this thing, here you see that this is the n type semiconductor and this is the metal. The metal is very heavily doped compared to semiconductor n, okay, because the number of free electrons in the metal is very high compared to the semiconductor, not heavily doped. The term doping is not applicable for metal. The exact term should be the number of free electrons on the metal side is more than the number of free electrons on the semiconductor side. So, the depletion layer will extend onto the semiconductor side. This rho s is the charge distribution. So, charge will be like this. Okay. and the electric field will be like this, it is one side. In PN junction you have seen that it will be on the other side also. On the PN junction it will be on the other side also. Here also it will not be very less in PN junction, it will have some appreciable area. So, the charge transferred to the metal from the semiconductor limits in very narrow n region, very narrow region at the metal surface. The extent of charge in semiconductor is W, that is rho s is equals to q into n d for x less than W, and that is equals to 0 for x greater than W. That we have seen in the, we have shown in the graph also. The magnitude of the electric field is decreasing linearly with distance. The maximum electric field is EM, located at the interface. Maximum electric field is located on the interface. Okay. Now, you know that the electric field is given by minus dv dx, and that is equals to q n d by epsilon s w minus x. From where it comes? It comes from the Poisson's equation. And that equation is basically related to the electric field and the, or the potential and the charges, potential and the charges, the relation between the potential and the charges. So, it comes from the Poisson's equation and it is this value. This is equals to EM minus q n d by epsilon s into x. Where is E m? E m is this thing, that is equals to E m. That means, E m equals to q n d w by epsilon s. What is epsilon s? Epsilon is the dielectric permittivity of the semiconducting material. Epsilon s is dielectric constant of the semiconductor. Now, voltage across the space charge by the area under the curve voltage across the pressure surge region is represented by the area under the field curve. Now, what is the area? Half base into altitude, half base is W, altitude is Em. So, that means it is equals to half of Em into W. Now, if you put the value of Em, you will get Q N D W square by twice epsilon s. So, that is V B I minus V, that means some forward bias we have applied. From this expression, we can calculate the value of the depletion layer with W. How? Very simple, W is given by root over of twice epsilon s V B I minus V by Q into N D. So, this is the width of the depletion region. Sure, it is okay. This is the value of the depletion region. Now, what is the space charge density in the semiconductor? Space charge density, that means total charge in the depletion layer. What is the, how it can be calculated? It can be calculated by, you see, total phase charge density, it is QSC, it is given by equals to Q N D into W. N D is the number of donors, W is the depletion layer width and Q is the charge. So, total charge is Q into N D into W. Now, you put the value of W here from this expression to here. So, what you will get? 2Q, yes, V B I minus V, very good. So, this is the total space charge. Remember that for forward bias, this V will be V F, for reverse bias it will be minus V R, yes, that means plus V R, sure. Now, from this space charge, you can calculate the capacitance. Charge divided by voltage is the capacitance. Okay. So, the capacitance, depletion layer capacitance, that is C equals to dQSC by dV, that is equals to root over of Q epsilon s N D by 2 V B I minus V, that is equal to epsilon s by W. Okay. So, this is the total capacitance in the depletion region, and what is 1 by C square? Right, that is the 1 by C square. Now, if we differentiate 1 by C square with respect to V, if you differentiate 1 by C square with respect to V, then what you will get? D 1 by C square by dV, that is equals to okay, sure, or N D is equals to 2 by Q S minus 1 by D of 1 by C square by D V. So, that means N D can be calculated from this expression. You see that Q is the electronic charge and epsilon s is the dielectric constant of the material. So, those are constant available from the literature. That means, if you can plot 1 by c square versus v, if you can plot 1 by c square versus v, then from the slope of that curve, you can calculate the value of the N d. And if N d is constant throughout the material, which will be there? If the doping is uniform, then N d will be constant throughout the material, then it will be a straight line. Then it will be a straight line. So, I can write down that 1 by c square versus v should be a straight line if N d is constant. Intercept at 1 by c square equals to 0 corresponds to what? Built in potential. That is V b I or V 0, same thing. So, from that curve, that means 1 by c square versus v, two important things we can obtain. One is the value of N d, that is from the slope of the curve, and another from the intercept of the curve v b I, right. Why? Because you see from this expression, when v equals to 0, equal to, that means when v b I minus v equals to 0, v will be v b I. So, from the intercept, you see that intercept at 1 by c square equals to 0 corresponds to built in potential v b I. Once you know v b I, you can calculate phi b n. Once you know v b I, you can calculate phi b n. So, that is also very important relation, and you see that in this plot, I have shown 1 by c square versus v. This is the intercept, that means 1 by c square equals to 0, this is the intercept, this is the intercept. So, from the intercept, you can calculate v b I, okay? And from the slope, you can calculate N d. So, 1 by c square versus v plot is very, very important for semiconductor. It is applicable for p-n junction also. If you want to calculate the barrier potential in p-n junction, you use 1 by c square versus v plot, or if you want to know the doping concentration, then also you can plot 1 by c square versus v, because that slope will give you the concentration of the carriers, right. So, 1 by, because you had in your mind that why 1 by c square, why we are making so much mathematics, it is because of this plot, because straightforward you can have from this graph, it is straightforward, because you see that you have to measure current or voltage or capacitance as a current or capacitance as a function of voltage, and you have to plot it. From the plot, you can straightforward, you can take the value and put to determine a particular parameter. Okay. Now, with this idea, let us solve this problem, this one. Find the donor concentration and barrier height of the tungsten gallium arsenide Schottky barrier diode from figure below. Compare the barrier height with that obtained from the saturation current density of this. Given this NC equals to 4.7 into 10 to the power 17 per centimeter cube, epsilon s equals to 12.4 and effective Richardson constant A star equals to 8 ampere per Kelvin square centimeter square. That means from this problem, you can calculate the barrier height from the CV, because it is given that from the figure below, and this figure is related to 1 by C square by V, 1 by C square versus V. So, now you try this problem. Find the donor concentration and barrier height. From JS it is very easy. From JS saturation current density is given, A star is given. So, first part is very easy, in this case the second part, you see that JS is equals to A star T square e to the power minus q phi b n by k t, or phi b n is equals to k t by q ln A star T square by J s, that is equals to 0.0259 ln A star is 8 into 300 square by J s is given, 5 into 10 to the power minus 7, you see it is given. So, it will be 0.72 electron volt. So, the barrier height is 0.72 electron volt, it is from the IV measurement. Remember that it is from the IV measurement. Okay? Clear? Any doubt? Now, from CV measurement, what is the value? The curve is given. The curve is given. So, once the curve is given, you see for gallium arsenide, you have to calculate 1 by d of 1 by C square versus dV, 1 that means you have to calculate d 1 by C square dV. Okay. So, if you consider this gallium arsenide curve, what is the value at minus 2? The value is 1 or 2. And what is the value at 0? 1.6, or you can take minus 1, what is the value? Right. So, you take the difference, 4.2 into 10 to the power 14, here you see it is 10 to the power 14, not this scale, this scale is for silicon, it is given, it is left scale is for silicon, right scale is for gallium arsenide. Okay. So, it is say 6.2 into 10 to the power 14 minus 3.9 into 10 to the power 14 by minus 1, because minus 2 minus minus 1. Okay. So, it is minus 1. So, thereby you can calculate, you see this value, you can calculate, this value you can calculate. So, if you know this value, then N d can be easily available, right. And N d for this case, N d for this case, you can write down 4.7 into 10 to the power 16 centimeter cube inverse. You can try in your room, 4.7 into 10 to the power 16, N d is given. Now, what is V n? What is V n? And what is V B I? VBI is
PT by Q ln NA into ND by NI square.
No, no, but from here you can calculate the intercept. Graph is given. So, the intercept you can calculate what is the value for gallium arsenide, it is say how much? 0.4 or 0.5, whatever be the case, say 0.4 volt. No, 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 0.4, that value. Okay. No, it is not 0.4, it is say you have to measure from 0, 0.6 or 0.7, say it is 0.7 volt, because you have to measure from 0, say it is 0.7 volt, right. So, you know ND, you know VBI. So, how to calculate phi B? Phi BN will be VN plus VBI. Phi B n equals to V B I plus V n, V B I is 0.7 volt and V n you have to calculate. What is V n? V n is the distance between the Fermi level and the conduction band. So, this V n is nothing but K T by Q ln N C by N D. This expression we have earlier deduced, because these are very useful expressions and always we have to make use of it. So, K T by Q ln N C by N D. So, if I calculate the values, you will find that V n is equals to K T by Q ln N C by N D, or K T by Q is 0.0259 multiplied by ln. N C is how much? 4.7 × 10⁻¹⁷. And 4.7 × 10⁻¹⁶ N D, this is equal to 0.06 electron volt. So, phi B n is equals to V B I plus V n, V B I is 0.7 from the intercept of the 1 by C square on V axis, of the intercept of 1 by C square at V equals to 0 equal plus 0.6, that is 0.76 electron volt. What was the value from IV measurements? 0.72. Here it is 0.76. So, almost you find that there is an increase of 5%. It is volt. This is also volt. If you multiply that volt with Q, it will be electron volt. It is very simple. The same value will be there. That means, see, here it is phi B n equals to 0.72 volt. If you multiply by Q, it will be 0.72 electron volt. It is very simple. Okay. So, you see that two different values we encountered. One is the phi B n from IV measurement, which is 0.72, and another is phi B n from CV measurement, which is 0.76. So, that means barrier height from capacitance is 4% larger than the barrier height from the IV measurements. And the reason is that there will be interface states, for that reason it will be different. It will be different, right. So, this is the example, and you take one homework. So, the earlier one and this one we have to submit by the next week, or by Friday this week. Today is Tuesday, yes, by Friday you submit it. In a piece of paper you write your name, roll number. We deposit a metal with a work function of 4.6 electron volt on silicon, the electron affinity is given as 4 electron volt, and acceptor doping level of 10⁻¹⁸ cm inverse. Draw the equilibrium band diagram and mark off the Fermi level, the bandages and the vacuum level. Is this a Schottky or ohmic contact and why? By how much should the metal work function be altered to change the type of contact? Explain with reference to the band diagram. Okay? Right? So, before this, you will get a copy. Before this, just let me introduce you the ohmic contact, because in this problem, ohmic contact is required, concept of ohmic contact is required. See, here the metal work function is less than the semiconductor work function. It is n-type semiconductor. The metal work function is less than the semiconductor work function. Then if you join, what will happen? Yes, electrons will come from metal and it will be accumulated on the semiconductor surface or interface. So, it will be accumulated. So, at the semiconductor surface, there will be more number of electrons compared to the bulk. In the Schottky case, what happened? More number of electrons were in the bulk compared to the depletion layer, because there was a depletion layer at the interface. Here, there is no depletion layer, rather there will be accumulation layer. And see, because of this accumulation layer, the band bends upward. For depletion layer, the band bends downward. Here it bends upward. And the mechanism is same, EC minus EF. The value of EC minus EF, you have to determine. Here at the interface, EC minus EF is very less. Why? Because there is more number of electrons, accumulation of electrons was there. So, if you consider this type of a diagram, suppose up to this point it is 10 to the power 17, it is okay, but if it is 10 to the power 20, then what will happen? This label will move very close to the conduction bandage, because of EC minus EF will be less. And if the value is sufficiently high, then it can even go upwards. Here you see that the band bending is was such that it even crosses the Fermi level near the junction because of the heavy accumulation of the electrons. So, that means whatever be the polarity, always there will be flow of electron from the metal to the semiconductor, from the semiconductor to the metal. Always there will be flow of electrons, not like your Schottky case. In Schottky case, there was a barrier. Here, there was no barrier, right? If you contact it with positive or negative, whatever be the polarity, the electrons will always flow from this direction to that direction or from that direction to this direction. So, that is known as the ohmic contact. Here, the contact resistance will be determined not by the interface, because there is sufficient number of electrons accumulated. So, the resistance is very, very less. It will be limited by the resistance of the bulk material. Okay? The current will be limited by the resistance of the bulk material. So, in ohmic contact, the flow of electron in both the sides, so thereby the current will be same. You use positive bias or negative bias, the reverse bias. It will be the same current that will flow from one end to the other, and it will be limited by the resistance of the bulk material, not else, right. So, that is the ohmic contact. So, that means if we start from this thing that here you see that we have started with this slide, that phi m greater than phi s for n type. We see that it is Schottky, and number 2 case, phi m greater than phi s for n type, it becomes ohmic. So, you expect that when phi m is less than phi s for p type, it will be Schottky, And when phi m is less than phi s for p type, it will be ohmic, right? The reverse thing will happen. Where? sorry, phi m less than phi s. Yes, it is, you see, it is phi m less than phi s, okay? So, it is n type, it is ohmic. So, now you are in a position to say when there will be ohmic contact, when there will be Schottky contact will depend on the metal work function and the semiconductor work function, okay? Thank you.